Everyone wants to be number one when it comes to improving their SEO ranking. And local ranking, of course, is a difficult thing to improve if you don't know what you're doing each week. So sometimes it's good to set aside a little bit of time each week and have a little process, a workflow that you follow and that you do on a regular basis. And what that will do is that will give a signal over time that you're an authority, that you're regular, you're trustworthy. Google just knows that when it goes to your website or your Google My Business information, that it's up to date and reliable. And that takes time to establish. So today's video is going to look a little bit more of what regular things can we do for LaRue window cleaning services to make sure that Google sees it as an authority and that Google knows it can trust it, that it's kept up to date. And also, how does it actually work? I mean, is it a case you wake up one morning and suddenly you're number one? Or is it a case of it's just a constant, gradual process, a little bit of percentage here, a little bit of percentage there, and over time you look back and see how things have changed? Well, most of you probably already know that there's no magic formula when it comes to getting lots of traffic in Google. And it is a little bit of a hare and tortoise way of thinking. Some people want to be dashing, getting number one straight away with no effort whatsoever. But if you have that tortoise method, recognizing as a compounding growth, then you'll really get there over time. And we're going to see what things will give it that compounding growth. In fact, we're even going to show you a bit later in the video what a compounding growth is. So this is part of a series where we're helping a business from absolutely nowhere on Google My Business. Over the past month now, we've been just checking in, doing a few tweaks. Today, we're going to help it get a regular workflow to help it with its boost in local SEO. So follow along, do it for your business, and make sure you haven't missed any of the previous episodes that's got us to this particular episode in the series.
So you can always invent your own workflow every time you log in. You may find there are things that continuously change and get updated. And it's always good to just see if Google wants something in particular. So I click on here, get started. And anything here that you can just answer. So for instance, here is a LaRue open. Yes, market open. So yep, we'll do that. So these are things just to clear. So part of your workflow needs to be perhaps just reacting to conversations that Google want with you. In fact, we'll just click save on those for now. Now you might feel, well, why bother doing all that? But that again is just giving Google a signal that your business is very much up and alive and very much wanting to do business. It's only interesting showing businesses that are very much interested in helping customers. Why? Well, because that makes sense. Google is wanting the best businesses for its customers, and then customers will continue to use Google to find new business. So it works for Google and it works for businesses. Now we're going to try and put together a workflow that's going to help you improve your SEO ranking today. That's what we're going to do. There's going to be some hidden gems in here as well, so look out for those. So the first thing I'd always do before I go any further is, you will just notice, is it having an impact, the things we're doing? Now, about a month ago, there was no views, there was no searches, there was no activity, because LaRue window cleaning services didn't exist as far as Google was concerned. And now within a month or so, within 28 days, we've now got it where all these pluses are coming through. People are finding the business. There is phone calls. My customers or my clients telling me that he has had phone calls come through, and there is activity. Also, another thing you'll notice is the posts are being kept up to date. So this one was just written regarding COVID, and you do want to continuously add new posts. We'll come onto that again in a moment. And as I come down here, one of the things we're going to look at in a future video, probably the next video, will be changing this, because this is a ridiculously long website name. So we're going to buy a domain, and I'm going to show you how to do that on a future video, probably the next one. And just working through here, there's a few other things. It's saying add logo. The logo has already been added. This is a bug. So if you've got this, as I've got it on all of my UK businesses, this is a bug that Google, for some reason, I even raised it with Google, they still haven't cleared this out yet. So I'm going to go back to the top, and the first thing I do, so there's going to be four things. So number one is check your insights. So we're going to insights, And Insights is growing, it's gradually changing. And one of the things you'll notice on Insights is it starts to tell you what's actually been happening. Now, this is great to see, but over the last few days, the green one is visits of websites. So on that occasion, there were two visits of website. There were two direction requests as well. So that's when they try and find you on Google Maps because they want to contact you. And the blue ones are phone calls. So in the last few weeks, we've had two phone calls by means of Google My Business. And again, this gives you an idea of what days are most successful when it comes to phone calls. So there's lots of information here. You notice also all other window cleaners, that's represented the average window cleaner in red. Whereas LaRue Windows, which was absolutely nothing here just a month ago, is hitting some pretty big figures already. 240 views of his photos, 236 on that particular day. And you'll find every time we add a few new photos, we're getting a lot more traffic through. So we're getting 257% more views than other window cleaners in the area. So again, just gives you a bit of information. And also what's been really good is I've encouraged the business owner to ask for customer photos. So looking at other window cleaners that have been around for maybe months or years, you notice they just have a few photos and a few customer ones. We've already managed to get two, so it looks like the average there is one. We've got two customer photos and 24 photos. So this is all going to prove to be a positive signal to Google in the coming months ahead. Now, the reason we're actually here is not to analyze the insights as such, but just to see if there's any keywords that we can use before we start writing anything. So I'm going to go down to here. We'll see that the only keyword at the moment that's being found is LaRue. So that's a shame, really. We're hoping to see things like window cleaning. I just click open more, but there is nothing else at the moment. So people are kind of giving a signal to Google that the branding LaRue is pulling in traffic. What we're going to want to do is increase the opportunity to get the word window cleaning services or poll system. We're trying to get that as being the next way in which people find the business. And once they find that business, well, then they'll continue to then hopefully become new customers in the local area. So Insights is one thing I do. And part of Insights is just also combining that with just seeing where you are. So you would have seen a previous video of how persuaded you can get free credits as well. And you can just see whether or not there is any increase. So you can run this on a weekly basis. So if I go to here, you'll see that I do a scan each week. And that will then tell me whether there's been any increase on Google My Business. So let's just go back to here. So we can see that at the moment, he's just starting out. But to get in the top 20 is pretty good because there's a lot more than 20 window cleaners in the Bournemouth area. So that's something that we're going to be monitoring in the months and weeks ahead. So Insights will give you keywords, which we haven't really got at the moment. It will also tell us, or we can measure, we're persuaded to see the success of what we're doing and measure that success. So the second thing you need to do once you've done Insights is you need to go into Photos. And what I would say again on a weekly basis is you just want to keep adding a photo. Now there's the proof, we've already got the logo. Adding videos is good, which we haven't done yet. Adding photos for an interior doesn't really apply for window cleaning. So to add a photo, so I've got again, my client has given me a photograph here. So he's just sent that through. So I'll just show you that. And again, he's trying to demonstrate that he can get to the heights using the poll system. So that's the purpose of that photo. So what we'll do, we'll upload that photo. You click on plus. And then just drag the photo across, let go, and that's it. And then that gives, again, another bit of information to Google. So you notice we posted a photo last week, 43 views. Last week, 245 views. 2 weeks ago, 32. So it does vary depending on the shot. And you'll notice that if you go back, some of the older ones probably will get more views. It's kind of difficult to understand why it is that some get more views than others, but this is a good selection. Make sure when you do upload photos that they're your own photos and not photos that are just taken from a website or belonging to someone else. Now, before I go on to the third thing that you need to do, I just wanted to talk for a moment about why are we doing this. And in effect, it's just exponential growth, or it's a compound growth. So what you're doing is the more photos you add, the more posts you add, the more ways in which you add keywords that are in line with the ones that you're being found on. The more effort you put into building up your reviews and the quality of your reviews, answering your reviews, answering any quotes, the more information you keep adding on a constant, regular basis, you're compounding upon what you've already got. So just, you know, if 100 photos brings one phone call in, then on that basis, do 200 photos and you'll get two phone calls a month. And if you did 500 photos, you get five phone calls a month. It's kind of a compounding effect that gradually grows. And then suddenly you'll find that Google breaks you through into another area where you'll suddenly be found under another keyword, and it goes on and on. And it's a bit like the old legend of having a grain of rice is doubled on each square. So the first square, it's one grain of rice, and then it comes two grains of rice, then four, and so on. What happens by the time you get to the 64th square? Well, you only need to get to just a few squares to see the compounding effect, the compounding growth that's shown by this illustration. What does this do? It just shows you that as you keep adding more posts, as you keep adding more photos, as you keep talking about the services you produce, and as you keep adding more and more to what Google asks of your business, just on a regular weekly basis, just half an hour, say a week, you will see a massive increase in the way in which that markets you to your local SEO. You'll then see the ranking boost that's often spoken about. But it does take effort and time. And most businesses aren't doing it, or if they are doing it, they're not doing it very well, because they don't really understand it. And that's the purpose of these videos. If you give it a thumbs up, then it'll help this video help others as well. So hopefully you're enjoying this video. Give it a thumbs up. And if you haven't subscribed, obviously do make sure you do that. Now I'll come to the third area. And the third area is all about posts. And there are different types of posts as well. We're going to add another post. So we've just done one a minute ago with a COVID update. So again, on a weekly basis, try and keep this up to date. It doesn't have to have much information. It doesn't even require a photograph. You'll see that just over a week ago, we did a photo or two on this one. Again, just illustrating some of the services. And with all posts, one of the things you need to do is make sure that really every single week you update it. Try and include the area you cover, so in this case Bournemouth. Try and include your business name with perhaps the area you cover. So we've got LaRue Window Cleaning Services there. Try and include the services you cover too. And then decide, do you want a call now button this time round, or do you want a link to your website, and so on. And you can just kind of keep varying this, really, just keep it natural. But this is building up, and as this builds up, this is just producing little mini pages on the website. So you would have saw the website in a previous video, but if I just click on there, here's the website, here's all the posts, here's all the reviews, which we'll come onto as well. It's just building it up gradually, and it's compounding the effect of what you're doing. So let's just go back to the posts, and I've written a post already. Again, some keywords involved, and we've already just uploaded a photo. So what we'll do, we'll write the post. If you add, here's a little bonus tip, if you add events, it produces an H1. So if you can come up with events, you do get some extra benefits from an SEO point of view, which we're going to come onto a video. I'll show you how to do that on a future video. But most of the time, we're just using what's new. So you click on add photos. And if you click on albums, you'll also see the ones you've already uploaded. So you can always, rather than uploading a new one, you can just use one that you've just uploaded. So here's one that we just uploaded a minute ago. So I'm going to click on that, and I'm going to use that as my main photo. Oh, in that case, the photo you uploaded is too small. So what I'll do is I'll add the original. There you go. So just goes to show that you have to keep an eye on things. This is then going to be copy and pasted in. So I just wrote this. So LaRue Window Cleaning Services. So that's there, producing or emphasizing that as a keyword. It's mentioned again as a keyword, window cleaning services, which is the main category. Then we've got a list of some of the other things that they offer. So that's good. And then again, LaRue services mentioned there, Bournemouth, Christchurch. Okay, good. So that's ready to go. And this time let's have a learn more. and that needs to take you through to a link. Actually, we're going to have a website next video, so let's actually not use the learn more. Let's go for the call now, and that will then give them an opportunity. You just preview it, just make sure, does that look good? Yeah, that looks fine. The photo's not really ideal, so let's just go back. So do we need to recrop? Yes, we do. So, okay, so that's good. So that gives a bit more clarity if we have it there. Just preview that. Okay, so we can now see that's there, fine, so we'll publish it. You can view it on search as well. And there you go, that's how it's going to look. And it always looks a double because this one is the latest one and then this one is the latest one. So it always doubles up because this is just showing how it looks, whereas this is showing your latest one. So don't worry about that, that makes sense. So we've gone number one, insights, number two, photos, number three, posts, and number four. Number four is replies and reviews. So when you have a review, we've also said the importance of replying to it. Now, I've asked my client to reply to them, but not just to say thanks, but to then say something personal so that it shows he's read what they've put, because they've taken time out to write a nice review. They've taken time out to give them 5 stars in all these cases, which is great to see. But what you need to do is make it personal and then also try and include mentioning of, say, areas. So he's mentioned Bournemouth and Southbourne here, which is good. Or mention a quality, so he's mentioned the services as a high standard, or mention something else like customer service. So this is really good. So what he's done is he's gone on each one of these and he's given them a little bit of an answer that's included things like his branding or his services. And that's just being polite, but at the same time, it's giving you a little bit of extra keyword. And they're all different as well, which is good. That's exactly what we want. So has there been any that he hasn't replied to? No, they've all been replied to, so that's really good as well. So there's the fourth thing, really, is just make sure you use keywords and also ask your customers if they can supply photos. I think he did say, or we saw two, didn't we? So I'm not sure where they are, but... And I think if you carried on doing these four things on a weekly basis, you're going to see growth. That doesn't mean that that's the only thing to be done, but those are kind of the bulk of the regular work you need to do if you want to see a boost in your Google SEO and in your Google My Business presence.
Now, hopefully you found some of those things really helpful and you've already now set aside time to work out what your workflow will be each week. And you will see an increase in traffic if you continually do this over the coming months ahead. But if you want a bit more detail on some of those things as well, if you want to know a little bit more about how I did each one of those things and a whole video on the detail of what to do, then head over to this video here. But if you'd be interested in knowing how you can make your free Google My Business website appear under a professional domain name, like a .com, then head over to this video and I'll see you there.